Hey everyone, it's Angela with Mystic Moon bringing you guys a Divine Feminine reading today. And so this is going to be for Divine Feminines that are on the Twin Flame journey. So we're going to be focusing on those of you that are experiencing a challenge or separation in your connection. We're going to be looking at the connection as well as messages that your Divine Masculine has for you today from his higher self. So the organites that we're going to be tapping into are the Divine Masculine and Feminine Nudes created by my friend Michelle from Wing and Bell. You can see these over here on the left-hand side. So I will put her information down below. These are sold in a pair. As far as any of the decks that I'm using here today, I will let you guys know what I'm using as I shuffle each deck, but any of the decks that I personally created will be available for purchase on my website. If you're international, please email my team and they will send you a special link to order. At the end of the day, you guys, just please take what resonates for you and leave what doesn't. So let's get into it. What we're going to do is we're going to tap into this deck first. This is from Angelic Revelation 144, the Emperor, Empress, Divine Love Oracle. So let's see what these cards have to tell us today. What kind of energies are coming through for this connection? My Divine Feminine. So this is from the masculine to the feminine. My Divine Feminine, you inspire me to be a beautiful reflection of who you are. As I focus upon my love for you, I am learning to see myself how you see me. I am ready to walk through the rest of my life with you. I no longer want anyone else but you. You have helped me open my heart to the truth of who I am, and I am eternally grateful to you. So some of you, that may make sense to you. And some of you, you might say to yourself, my masculine is not in that space right now. Well, this tells me here, this is where his higher self, that's why I said 5D energy. So this is where you and your masculine are in your pure form of who you truly are in this connection. So I feel that this masculine is communicating to this feminine from the 5D, that he is currently inspired by how beautiful she is. And he uses that as a reflection of who he really is. And he is trying to focus on this love. And it's through that that he's learning to see himself through her. So that way he can walk by your side through eternity. That is amazing. Okay. So that is from masculine. Let's see what else we get. Thank you for your never-ending patience with me. I know that I can be difficult and I struggle to trust. I am sorry that I have allowed my doubt in my heart. I am still healing from past trauma, but I cannot deny my heart belongs to you. So to me, this is very much an extension from Divine Masculine, again, saying thank you for your never-ending patience with me. Thank you for still loving me despite maybe any walls or any doubts that I may have had about our connection or on this journey. So his heart belongs to his feminine, but he may still be healing from past traumas. And last one, you have captured my heart, my eternal love. From the first time I dreamed of you, I loved and adored you. This love I have for you is never ending and ever present. My heartfelt desire is for you to walk through all the days of your life knowing you are truly the love of my life. I mean, those are some pretty intense energies, but this is about eternal energy, eternal love. Being, you know, my heart belongs to you. You're the love of my life. You are the person that I want to, you know, you're the person that is basically my counterpart. So those are messages from masculine from the 5D. These are the things that are coming straight from his ascended being, from his heart space. So let's go into my depths of the sea oracle and see what comes through as far as what's going on with this masculine right now in his mental space. What's going on there? Okay, well, we have feminine. So the feminine is on the masculine's mind. Feminine is definitely there. So he's thinking about her. This is the Oracle of Mermaids. What is the energy? Wow, we have the unseen. She may not know that. She may not see that he is connected to her. He may not, or she may not see him in the physical world. He might hide from her. So he's very receptive. He's very open to this love that he feels for the feminine, but she may not see it. So that could present some sort of doubt for her. What about his emotions? Storms ahead. Poseidon. Freedom. Okay, so in his heart space, what I'm getting here, it's kind of stormy. He may be very determined to be free. He may be very determined to stand on his own or get, like, weather a storm or whatever storm has been created. He wants to weather through that. He's determined to do something on his own. And maybe this is not something the feminine is actually seeing any physical evidence of in the physical world. She may just see him as not caring. She may see him as he just wants to be without her. She may see him in a certain way. But he actually is very open to the connection, but it just might not be in the way that she is seeing it, if that makes sense. So what's going on in the physical world? Okay, well, we have Zen. This masculine could be spending some time meditating, becoming more aware of himself, working on himself. Yeah, saying goodbye to any cycles that no longer serve him. Farewell to the moon, which is farewell to illusion, certain cycles that need to cycle through. Becoming more aware of how he wants to grow and how he wants to heal. What is the overall energy here towards the feminine? Yeah, trying to have some sort of a positive mindset when it comes to the both of them. So I feel like this masculine wants to improve. Yeah, look at that, yearning, longing for someone, undesired separation. So he's trying to remain positive about this separation is what I'm getting. He's trying to remain positive, perhaps, that they will see each other once again, but he's working on himself. He's hell-bent on getting through a storm. He's hell-bent on weathering a storm and getting through maybe some sort of storm that he has created in his own life, picking up the pieces. Maybe he doesn't want to drag the feminine through his stuff. And so he's becoming aware on his own that he needs to take care of these things on his own. So from his higher self, that might be one of the reasons that he's telling her, thank you for being patient for me or with me. You've captivated my heart and I'm open to this connection with you and I yearn for you, but I need to be in a better mind space than I am right now. And so that might be one of the reasons that you're not hearing from me. So that we're in this separation. So at the end of the day, you know, what does the masculine want? What does he truly want besides working on himself, besides just being at a distance? Let's go into my twin flame journey oracle. Okay, well, we have recognition. I feel like, yeah, it's like he recognizes that this, wow, we have the answer is no. So let's clarify what this means before I speak any further. He recognizes the divine feminine, but the answer is no right now. As in, this isn't the right time, not ready. I can't right now. Yeah, see, I need a new perspective. My heart's on lockdown right now. I recognize you though as my counterpart, but there's a huge, like, you know, but. Yeah, see, I see you as the Queen of Pentacles. This person, like, I see your value. I want to be with you. I long to be in your embrace, but the answer is no. See, yeah, I have to manifest something on my own. Number one is my own energy, me alone. I feel like this masculine is hell-bent on weathering a storm alone, and he doesn't want to involve the feminine. So until he can gain some sort of new perspective, until he can clear the storm or these cycles, it's like he doesn't want to involve her in his energy. You were the best thing in my life. So he definitely sees her value. He recognized her value as the Queen of Pentacles. I replay our conversations over and over again. So he could be thinking about something that, you know, something that was said. I really hid who I really am from you. Now, this could be a little bit of this energy. Hiding. Hid from this feminine. See, I hid who I really was from you. I held back with you. I know I messed everything up. He created a storm. That's what I'm getting here. That Poseidon energy is his. He created a storm. He created a storm. He hid who he really was from her. Now that he's in this energy of breaking free and being in this more aware state of himself, he is trying to shift to more of a positive mindset for her so he can be receptive to the feminine of what she really has to offer him, which is all of these things. But the biggest thing is, I'm sorry that I have allowed my doubt to get into my heart space. So his doubt messed everything up. His doubt created the storm. His doubt caused him to hide who he really was from her. He replays the conversations over and over again and realizes that she was the best thing in his life. That's what he is recognizing now. But he also recognizes that the answer is no right now, that he has the tools that he needs in order to correct this and in order to come together with her to have a successful union. So he knows he's not ready. That is what we are seeing. He knows that he is not ready. So let's go ahead and see what are some of these challenges and shadows. This right here is the Moody Moon Messages Masculine Edition from Sister Moon Tarot. We have insincere. I'm just getting that. This masculine is not going to be able to be 100% sincere for this feminine right now. So he purposely stays away from her. He's in the middle of the storm with himself. Yep, look at that. Dictator of decay. This is a masculine who's trying to still shed his exterior. The dictator of decay is the King of Pentacles, but the King of Pentacles in shadow. King of Pentacles can be somebody who's power hungry, power lust. It's all about the outside instead of the inside. It's somebody who's trying to obtain power rather than, you know, being zen, which we can see the masculine is actually really wanting or working on. But there is still this outward ego type of desire that he has that may cause him to be insincere. He may not really truly be able to or is ready to be the King of Pentacles to match the Queen of Pentacles, which we can see he's very aware that that's what this feminine needs. So if he can't show up as the King of Pentacles, then why would he come at this time? So I'm getting here. The answer is no right now. I'm sorry. I can't come at this time. His higher self, yes, feels the connection, is aware of the connection, but his 3D self is really suffering. Most definitely. We have Sad. And the thing is, it doesn't make him happy that this is happening. It actually does create some sort of grief, undesired separation, longing for her, sad. And it just sucks that this is the way that it is. But I'm getting here that this masculine might be hell-bent on punishing himself too. Yeah, look, ten of rage, boiling point. Just dropping the burden, dropping everything in his life. He doesn't want to be a burden to anyone. He doesn't want to be a burden to the feminine. So it's just easier to just drop the connection and just focus on himself. We have communication. When he communicates with her, he wants it to be open and honest and truthful. And I'm just getting that right now, he wouldn't be able to be truthful and honest with her because he doesn't really truly know himself, but he is working on this. He's working on this, you guys. That's what I'm getting here. Yeah, Three of Swords. He's going through any kind of wounds of the flesh, wounds that have been created from the outer world, torment in his mind, wounds that he may have created or inflicted upon the feminine or even other people besides the feminine. He wants to be able to communicate when he has cleared these wounds, when he has addressed these heartbreaking wounds, when he has addressed who he is as a person. So Ten of Wands tells me this has been a real burden for this masculine and he's tired of being this way and he does want to change, but he's not ready. He's still in the cycle. And that's why we got this card here. Farewell to the moon. I have to say goodbye to these cycles that are no longer serving me. I need to get out of these stormy, choppy waters. Yes, I'm sad. I do miss the feminine. I yearn for her. I might even kind of be hiding or lurking somewhere in the shadows, but I need new perspective. And until I can gain the tools that I need, the answer is still going to be no. Yes, I'm hiding from you. Yes, I replay our conversations. Yes, I know that you were the best thing in my life, but I need a new perspective before I can recognize your true worth and potential so I can give you everything that you need. So I need freedom. I need time on my own to figure this out so I can become receptive. I'm working on having a better mindset so I can bring you more positive energy. So maybe I can correct this behavior. Do you see? So that's where this masculine is at this time. So let's see what's going on with your journey. Okay. What is the journey towards ascension right now? what's happening on this journey, the connective energy, the lessons and the energy that connect the feminine and masculine. This is called the Transcendent Journeys Oracle. Ooh, commune with your power animal. So there could be a power animal right now that could be significant to the feminine or the masculine. And so this could have something to do with their journey. That's what I'm seeing here, something to do with the journey. So we're going to tap into, hold on for just a second, I want to make sure I'm not using a deck I've already used. Let's go into, hold on for a sec. Where are my decks? I have a bunch of decks in front of me, but I'm looking for one specific. Where is it? I don't know why I can't find it. Oh, here it is. Sorry, guys. On the Horizon Tarot by Jennifer Aquarius Tarot. Whoa. Wow, we have Queen of Cups. Okay. Loving. Commune with your power animal. Feminine. But I'm also getting that this masculine is communing with a power animal in order to open up his heart space to be more loving. So there is some sort of work that's being done through animals right now. So there's a significant animal that is helping masculine and feminine to connect with themselves, with their emotions, also to tap into psychic energy or what might be going on in the minds. So feminine, if you know that your masculine is working with a specific power animal, or there's certain animals that you're seeing that are connecting you to your masculine, look up the meanings of those things, because I feel like there's hidden information that has something to do with how he's feeling and what he's going through when it comes to this journey. We have Nurture Your Tribe. Beautiful. I feel like other people on this journey are actually like creating some sort of a platform for future growth. So they're assisting friends, family, even other partners at this time could be assisting with this growth and development of yourselves on the journey. Yeah, the Star, things are being, they're aligned. This is helping us to heal. So other people are essential for our healing. So that's why to remain open to other things on your journey. It doesn't have to be romantic, even though it could be, but remain hopeful, remain in that state of having faith that you're being led down a certain pathway for a reason, okay? Things are coming together the way that they're supposed to in divine timing. We have listened to your heart, beautiful. that's where the answers really are, is in the heart space. Trust yourself, trust your heart. Your heart doesn't lie. And we have the Wheel of Fortune, divine timing. See, trust and have faith that everything is going to happen exactly the way that it's supposed to and the correct timing. And we do know that the masculine is very much in the energy of no, right now is not the correct time for me. Right now, I am just not at a level with myself to where I can show up for you. So respect my time on this journey right now, respect my space on this journey, and know that I am still working on me and finding me. But finding me means finding my way back to you. So trust that feminine. It's beautiful. All right, so how is spirit, you know, just assisting? Let's get into Divine Connections Oracle by Queen of Light 1111. How is spirit assisting, helping? Okay, we have peace. We have peace. So this right here is 3D and 5D peace and unawakened feminine. Interesting. So what does this have to do with? This right here is my Signs from Spirit Love Oracle. I really like that, because this to me is like the magician's energy that just came up for the masculine, which is, I'm not ready right now. I need to use my own tools and figure out how to create or manifest what I truly want and desire. I have a lack of tools right now, and I'm still trying to figure out what to do with these tools. So this is, the power lies within our own hands. You're a magical creator. Your thoughts are beginning to manifest. So you can be in a peaceful state right now and manifest peace in your connection on a 3D and a 5D level. That's what I'm seeing with that card. Because it's very important what vibration you're holding for your masculine. So we have unawakened feminine. Indestructible, meaning this isn't going to destroy you. this separation, the sadness, everything that you've endured so far on this journey, it's only made you stronger. So if you feel like you just still aren't getting it, if you still feel like you're just stuck, Spirit's saying, really celebrate how far you've come. Try not to focus on the negatives, okay? Yeah, see, maturity. It's all about, you know, we're growing and healing every second of every day. So give yourself a little more credit than you're giving yourselves. And also what we're getting to is that this masculine has the tools now, but what he's going to do with it, this will also help him on his journey to mature into the masculine that this feminine needs him to be. So in some sort of way, this feminine is being asked to kind of accept that this masculine is still in a little bit of a sleepy state, okay? And to focus more on other things, such as being in peace with the masculine, but also focusing on what you came here to create. So that helps to shift the vibration to a more peaceful state. Beautiful. So we're going to go into some messages from the masculine, from his higher self to the feminine, or just what he wants her to know. Divine Masculine Confessions by Bridget Rao. What does he want the feminine to know? And what we're going to do is we're going to tap into my Divine Feminine Healing cards just to kind of get a little bit of a subject. Okay, breathing room. See, I trust in the process of divine timing. Keeps coming up. So this masculine needs some breathing room and the feminine just needs to give it. Oh, see, this masculine, I'm telling you guys, it's almost like he feels like this feminine is better off without him. Better off without him for now. Not forever, for now. He needs to weather this storm alone and he doesn't want to include the feminine, and this shit storm is what I keep getting. So just give him that time that he needs. You're not sitting around twiddling your thumbs, waiting or putting your life on hold. So that's not what we're talking about. Beautiful. See the sunny sides. I will not let past challenges rob me of opportunities to be happy in the future. Again, you're not just sitting around, and your masculine doesn't necessarily want you to sit around and wait for him either. But he knows that right now the answer is no. He knows right now that you're better off without him for now. I'm gathering courage to reach out to you. So again, he's still trying to gather up courage. He's still trying to grow. He's still trying to own something within himself. He's still trying to own his power, step into his power. Absolutely. So try to see the sunny side and focus on the sunny side while he is still trying to gather up courage and strength. Yeah, his alienation isn't about you, feminine. It says the act of isolation stems from fear of intimacy. Don't take this behavior personally or try to force anyone to open up. The masculine has to come to these conclusions on his own. He has to. Can't force this. Nights are the worst for me. It's as if all my feelings are amplified. So this could be that this masculine, when he is alone, kind of in isolation, this is really hard for him. A lot of things are intensified, amplified for him. He might be feeling a lot of energy when he sleeps. So if you're connected to this masculine through dreams, I feel like he is also equally influenced by either fears popping up or even desires or fantasies when it comes to the feminine. Yeah. All right. So let's go ahead and get a few more here. We have future. Shift your focus on present events rather than what's ahead. The future is not meant to be known. Exactly. It's interesting to me when people want to know about the future. No one can accurately predict the future. People's free will comes into play and shifts things around. So no future is set in stone. So the thing is, really shift your focus to the present rather than focusing on if and when the masculine and you are going to come together. Just focus on your present energy. I never wanted to hurt you. I'm sorry. So the thing is, this masculine never had the intentions of hurting you, feminine. So if he did, he is saying that he is sorry. And tribe. So I don't know why I felt like tribe came up. Just double check here. Yeah, honor, nurture your tribe. Tribe. I understand that every soul I encounter has crossed paths with me for a reason. I am blessed by all interactions. This is also another reminder that other people on your journey are going to be essential for your healing and growth and development. Don't hold back. Jump in and give it to me, all of you. Set the pace so I can too. Interesting. So this is telling you here that regardless of who you get involved with, the masculine doesn't want you to be completely closed off for him, closed off to him forever. So his higher self definitely connects with you in this way where, yes, you know, the connection, it's very divine, 5D energy. It's all about being connected. You guys are one. But in the 3D, we can see that he's very much not ready. But he's telling you from his higher self here, he doesn't want you to hold back when the time comes. He wants you to be able to be open and vulnerable and give him the second chance or whatever many chances it's been. He wants you to basically set the pace so that he can jump in too. He doesn't want this separation or whatever has happened to you to damage you to where you're not able to let him in later on when he's ready. And it's not about, oh, because he's ready, now I have to be. If you're in that energy, then you're not ready. You're still stuck in ego. You still haven't healed. This is a soul connection. So it's about two souls coming together and celebrating that they're both ready at the same time. So union occurs when both souls are no longer willing to put their guards up and to play games and tit for tat crap. This is about two people coming together where they're both ready to strip down and not hold back. That song Stripped from Depeche Mode, it's coming to mind. That's the energy right there that's coming through. And I think I posted that song a couple of weeks ago as one of my songs of the day on my Instagram. So look up the lyrics. It's like, you know, let me see you strip down to the bone. And it's just like, yes, come and bear it all. So practice, what I'm seeing here is practice with other people on your tribe, meaning if you're having a difficult time trusting or opening up your heart or playing games with people, or you're feeling slighted and insecure, use people on your tribe to help you to like teach yourself or to heal yourself, to strengthen you for this connection later on with your masculine. If you find yourself holding back with other people on your tribe, if you find yourself, you know, taking everything personally with friends or family in your tribe, these are really good teachers for you as to how you're probably going to be when the masculine comes back. So use these teachers to help to strengthen you so that way you don't have to be so, you know, sensitive. And not like there's anything wrong with being sensitive, but you don't have to take everything so personally, because that is hell. Taking everything so personally, everything that everyone does, taking everything like it's so personal is a freaking hell. And if you're doing that with your friends and family, you're most definitely going to do it with your masculine. So, and that's going to create issues right from the very beginning. So use this time in separation and spending time with other people on your tribe to help you to heal anything that's holding you back from being able to be vulnerable. That's what the masculine is telling you, feminine. Wow. Okay. So let's, I'm not able to use all the cards here. I have a limited amount of time this morning. I didn't want this to be a super long reading as usual. So if there's certain card creators that I usually use your decks and I'm not using it today, it's nothing personally. It's just, I'm running out of time. Let's take a look and get, what does your masculine desire with you the most? Like, what is he currently desiring? We already know that he's saying no. We already know that he's having a difficult time showing up for this connection. We already know these things, but what does he truly desire at this time if he didn't have these fears? So let's go into the romance angels with my arrows of love oracle. Wow. Proposition and engagement. Well, first of all, your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. What does this masculine truly want? Well, he does want to get to a higher level of commitment with you when he's ready. So it's not like you're just that person that he wants to just have a casual connection with. No, he wants to have some sort of a higher level of commitment with you. And there's also a higher level of the commitment that you guys have made to help your souls to ascend in this lifetime. So this isn't just your run-of-the-mill connection. This is a commitment that you guys made to each other that's much higher than just being together in the physical world. So what he wants with you is he wants to complete this ascension. He wants to be able to be in this higher love. Another song from Depeche Mode. I don't know why it keeps coming through, but it does. Transformative. Yeah, it's like to have a love that transforms, that just like transcends, that's just out of this world. That's what he wants. He wants like the highest form of love. And it's through this forgiving and learning, as you release and heal the past, you guys are going to experience more of this ascended love in your present moment. So this masculine really wants to do the work. He really wants to do the groundwork of clearing himself. And he wants the feminine to also do the same. So that way they can come together and experience this highest form of love. Wow. So what he truly desires is a greater love, is a higher love. Yeah. And we have interference. Doesn't want anything to interfere ever again. It's very important that you feel safe to open yourself up and to open up your heart. So that way you guys can experience the highest energy of all without any more interferences. So why come together now when there's going to be nothing but interferences? Why come together when people aren't ready? Why struggle? This masculine wants to like get all of that stuff out of his system first and then come together when he is truly ready and he's just not feminine. At least the ones I'm channeling for today, he's just not ready. And so, but this pure energy that he feels with you is worth waiting for, is what I'm getting too. Yeah. So let's see with the Soul Activation Oracle deck from Rising Sun Oracle. Let's go ahead and see the projected future. Okay, even though we can't predict what's exactly going to happen, but what direction are things headed at this time? What are the unfolding of the events most likely to occur? Well, we have values, throat chakra. So this is about two people having a conversation and saying we're on the same page. Twin flame journey messages for myself. We're on the same page finally. But see, it's easier to just stay away right now. So until your values can align, there's a separation here. That's what I'm getting here. Wisdom. Yeah, somebody needs to learn. They need to understand something on their own. They need to gather up the wisdom. Would you reject me? You know, again, it's like any kind of feelings of doubt or any kind of feelings of being rejected or not worthy or not good enough. This is going to be connecting with the higher realms. This is going to help people to become more positive or to become, it's like that masculine wants that positive mindset to be able to come towards the feminine. This is how he gets it, is by tapping into his inner wisdom, by tapping into himself to become more aware of who he is. Yeah, and integrity. Acting with integrity, making decisions in integrity. I got spooked. So I feel like, again, if this masculine is afraid and still has fears, he's going to continue to not make great decisions. So feminine, why would you want this masculine in your life if he is not ready to commit? That's kind of what I'm getting here. So projected energies depends on the work that he does on himself. And that's going to take time. It's like that heart space. In your heart, you know that the timing isn't right. You know it. And you still love your masculine regardless. And he still loves you regardless. And we have present. So just be in the present moment. Focus on the present. Don't focus on the past. Don't focus on the future. Focus on the here and now. And the here and now, it's about being in a much better headspace with each other. And a much better heart space with each other. That's going to make all the difference in the world. So what this is saying for the projected future is that if these fears are not taken care of, if people are still in this energy here where they're not aligned, then this is not going to spell out a successful future. So rather than focusing on the future, focus on the present and realize that divine timing is at work here, and wait for this masculine to get into a much better headspace so that way he can give you what you're looking for in the present. So until he gets there, it's like there's still this energy of fear. There's still this energy of being blocked. There's still this energy of not being able to move forward because there is still that just fear. I just keep getting fear over and over again. So because we're getting so much fear, let's go into the Dark Night of the Soul Tarot. Shadowy energy here. What has got this masculine so afraid and so spooked? Wow. We have the Empress and the Seven of Swords. I feel like this masculine either lied, cheated, something on the feminine. So there is a lot of, how can we grow? How can we heal? This is the Untold Truths of the Heart Oracle by Aqua Moonlight. Yeah, time. Only time's going to tell. Only time can tell what's going to happen here. A lot of divine timing energy is coming through. Yeah, through time, I'm going to get more clarity so that way I can be honest and truthful with you so we can come into harmony, peace, balance. You see? That peace came up two times. It's absolutely necessary that we are in this peaceful state with one another. Wow. And yeah, so that way we can basically take off again. That way we can have this voyage. We can only go up from here. But this is a time to move in a new direction. It's a wake-up call. Things need to change. We need to go from this black, lack, rebellious, pessimistic energy. The only way forward is to get rid of this old energy. And I feel like this masculine is still locked away in this old energy, which is why the key is to unlock it, to move forward, to be able to voyage forward. That's what that is. What else? Caution. Yes. So this is my spirits of darkness and light. This is telling me here that the stranger is the masculine. He's protecting his feminine against him. Caution, warning. He's full of danger. He still has a lack. He's still in this energy of the fae, which is mischievous energy, playing fantasy, still not wrapping his head around reality. And he's still trying to find certain things and like look at things from a different perspective, have an advantage. He feels like he's at a disadvantage, so there's no point in him coming towards the feminine because he's at a disadvantage. But we have power, strength, and expression. And we have an unclear, confused, shady energy still. So he cannot properly get through this or express himself until he clears the shadiness or this hazy energy. Yeah. What is, let's get some physical, like sexual energies here. Okay. Let's get some sexual energies here. Love and Lust Oracle by Fire Witch Tarot and the 50 Shades of Love. Let's get some sexual desires. Your love has stolen Cupid's bow and they're aiming it straight at you. Love is in the air. One woman, man. Okay, so the thing is, I do feel with the Seven of Swords and the Empress's energy that this masculine may not have always been a one woman man. But this right here is telling me what he desires deep down is to be that person for this feminine. That's what it is. He desires to be this person for the feminine. The moment that you've been waiting for has finally arrived. Your love interest is about to confess their love to you. Shadow work, but he's got to go through a shadow work first before he finally confesses his love. So as soon as we get like this green light, yes, yes, then we get this no. The reason that this is happening is that's the energy of the masculine right now. He's not ready. He's just not ready to come forward. He's got his direction, like the bow and the arrow is directed towards the feminine because he knows that she is that one for him, but he has the shadow work that he is still struggling with. So that makes it very difficult. You have a deep hunger for your beloved. They have been away for far too long. The cravings are getting stronger. Soon you will have to hunt for their love. So strong. Yeah. See, meant to be. It's only a matter of time. This hunger, this vibration, this magnetic attraction that you guys have towards one another, it's only going to work in driving you closer and closer together in this life. So you're not going to be able to fight it forever. The masculine isn't going to be able to fight it forever. It's only a matter of time. But one thing that we do know that he needs is time. He definitely needs time. So let's go ahead and just basically close up this reading with some final thoughts and messages from Spirit. This is the, I'm not sure what that deck is called. That is the When Spirit Speaks. And this is the Twin Flame Angel numbers that I created. Final messages from Spirit. We have, okay, two no's in a reading. Spirit's saying something. Yep, be here in the present moment. That already came up. These are just confirming at the end. We're confirming what we already brought, and we have spring. There will be growth here again in this connection, but it's a matter of timing. It's a matter of timing before you guys can grow, for sure. Intuitive nudges. So while this masculine is in the energy of no, he will continue to receive messages from his higher self, from also this 5D energy where we can see that he connects with the feminine. The most intuition is the language of the soul. We are all born aware with a profound sense of inner knowing. Intuition is one of the greatest gifts we possess, which keeps us connected to our higher selves, the universe, and to our divine spirit. So just because the masculine is lost in the physical world and his 3D self saying no right now doesn't mean that he is like neglecting his higher self and what his soul is telling him. So just because it's a no right now doesn't mean it's going to be a no forever. See, the necessary seeds have been planted in the masculine on the journey. Remain patient as they begin to gestate. So this is just telling you this masculine is in this state of growth, development, awakening, ascending. 222. So if you guys are seeing twos, this is reminding you that the seeds have been planted. But you have to remain patient as these things take time. So in the meantime, be in the here and now. Try not to worry or waste so much time in the future or even in the past. Be proud of how far you've come. It says it's time to celebrate all that you've achieved, all that you are, and all that you will become. For once in a while, it's important to stop and acknowledge what you've achieved and also to be proud. So this is also telling you, try not to get stuck in that way of thinking, I'll be happy when, or, you know, not appreciating where you're at right now in your journey, not feeling good enough. Oh, I haven't worked hard enough, or I haven't completed enough, or I haven't reached a pentacle of success in this or that. Try to just be happy with what you have today. Seven, seven, seven. Honor your shadow self and let it reveal any hidden mysteries to you. A completion is near. So this is also about honoring that you've had to go through some stuff. When we're dealing with our shadows or when we're going through shadow work, we might not see that as a success. We might see them as failures. We might see that, oh my God, I gave into this, or I said this, or I said that out of my shadow, or out of fear, or out of ego. Every single time you fall on your face and you make mistakes, you're actually learning. So Spirit's telling you, be proud of yourself. Even if you feel or you're ashamed of yourself or you wish you wouldn't have done this or done that, be more in that proud energy and realize that you're completing major cycles through your heart space as well. That's a green energy, heart chakra. See that? Both of them are green. So that tells me here, wow, and this too, this is earth energy and the reds are chakras. So this is like where we're at in 3D and this is heart space energy. So the seeds have been planted in the root energy in the 3D world. Now what we're doing right now in our journey is we're going into our heart space and we're going into our shadow selves. We just saw that the masculine is in a shadow self, right? Honoring who he truly is and revealing any mysteries. You're doing the same, feminine. So a completion is near with this process. 7 + 2 = 9. That means that we're on the verge of a completion of a cycle. So we have spring. So why? So we can spring into new energy. So we can grow. So we can have a fresh new start. I see spring as fresh energy. And embrace the moment. It says, embrace this day, this very moment. Think positively in today and repel those negative thoughts. Try not to judge yourself or others. This may be harder than you think. What is actually happening is what is that you're changing your energy. So that is what Spirit is saying. We can't change what happened in the past, and we can't control what's going to happen in the future. All we can do is embrace the moment, and we can change our vibration, which has an effect on what we attract into our lives in the future. So Spirit is asking you to change your thoughts and you change your life. Adopt a more positive mindset today and you will start to see the blossoms of new energy basically unfolding before your very eyes. Last message, 232. Romance yourself as a way of attracting more of this energy into your life. So this is about vibration. When we want certain things, let's just say we want people to appreciate us more, but we don't appreciate ourselves. We want somebody to tell us how amazing we are, how beautiful we are, but we're saying nothing but trashy things to ourselves, cutting ourselves down with cutting remarks. The vibration that you're holding isn't going to attract someone else to come in to be able to, you know, it's not going to be a match. So this is about starting with your own self first. If you would like someone to show you how much they care, show yourself how much you care for you by taking care of yourself. Maybe do nice things for yourself. Maybe you're a person that's always doing things for everyone else. You're always taking care of everyone else, but not yourself. You're going to attract maybe somebody that's going to want you to take care of them. So do you see? We're attracting the energy that we're holding on or the things that we believe about ourselves. So Spirit's telling you to shift this energy, this orange energy right here, right? That is the sacral chakra. And the sacral chakra is about intimacy. It's about partnerships. It's about how we connect with other people. So how people connect with you has a huge, but it's going to be determined with how you connect with yourself. So if you don't connect with yourself in a positive way, then other people aren't going to be able to connect with you in a positive way. So start changing up your energy. Start shifting your vibration today in order to attract what you're looking for and what you desire. And so when you do this, you're going to get into alignment in your life. That yellow energy is like solar plexus energy. So I'm kind of seeing like this, the earth energy here, root energy, sacral energy, solar plexus energy, heart energy. So we've got, you know, all of the lower chakras. What the only thing that's missing here is the throat, the third eye, and the crown. So what I'm getting here, you guys, is that your journey right now, the seeds have been planted. It's just about continuing to grow and continuing to balance these energies within yourselves to help you and your twin flame to come into alignment. You guys are on the path. You guys are on your way. You guys are walking the steps. You guys are doing the work, but you guys are both doing it in very different ways. And so Spirit, I feel, is asking the feminine at this time to realize that it does take time and patience in order for one twin flame to awaken to the connection and to ascend to that level to where they want all of that beautiful intimacy, that they want that higher love. I already see this masculine wants this higher love, but he just may not have awakened or opened himself up yet to that key, you know, to unlock that part of himself to get there. But it's there. but it just, he's got some work to do. He's got to face some shadows. He's got some things he's got to do first. So in the meantime, feminines, don't dwell on the past. Don't lose yourself in the future. And focus more on you in the present moments and by shifting up your own energies and working on yourself and just doing your own thing. So anyways, I hope that that resonated with you guys. If it didn't, no worries. But yeah, I hope that you enjoyed it. Take care. Bye-bye.